Hey y'all, I'm James Wright and welcome to my shop. Today we're going to be talking about secondary bevels and back bevels. When should you use them, how do they help, and do I use them? Let's dive in. So first off, let me start off by saying, no, I don't use a secondary bevel on my chisels, and no, I don't back bevel on my plane blades. And I'll talk about why, but does that mean that I think that it's bad to do so? No, I actually think that there's a lot of good reasons for it, and there are reasons that you may want to do it. And I want to actually cover those and show you some of the things about each individual one. So first off, I want to take a look at chisels and look at secondary bevels. So let's actually draw this out and start with this one down here. Imagine that this is our chisel. So our chisel is sitting right here, and we have just honed this down. We have this edge really nice and true. What we can do is we can put a secondary bevel on there right here, and that is going to increase the angle of attack on the chisel here. So if we're sharpening the chisel at 30 degrees, then this may be at like 32 degrees or 34 degrees or somewhere around 35 degrees, anywhere in that range, and you have a secondary bevel. It's just a little bevel right at the very tip. If you're freehand sharpening, that means you take it from your primary bevel and then you lift the handle up just a little bit for the last few strokes to do the very end. And that's just going to put a tiny, tiny little bevel right on the front edge. If you're sharpening with a jig, you will sharpen it at the main bevel. And with one like this, you can actually flip this out and move the detent over. And this will actually raise the jig up a little bit so you can make a few more strokes at a different angle. And that way you can have a preset to put a secondary bevel on there. If you're doing it on a grinder or some other power tool like that, then there may be other detents or sets so you can actually change that angle. And one of the questions is, why exactly would you want to do that? Different woodworkers are going to have different reasons for doing it, but for the most part, it means that it's going to be a little bit easier to sharpen the next time, because rather than always sharpening on the primary bevel, then you can just sharpen it on that secondary bevel. You could keep that secondary setting on this, and so every time you're just sharpening that tiny little bit at it, and it can make sharpening much, much faster because you're just using that tiny bit at the front. If I'm riding that whole bevel with it right on the plate, I'm going to be spending a lot of time taking off all that material all the way along that bevel. But if I put it up onto a secondary bevel like this, then I'm just taking the material off of the very tip. That means that sharpening is a lot faster and a lot quicker. And so what some people do is they will always sharpen it on that secondary bevel. And so every time they sharpen it, it's going to go back a little bit farther and a little bit farther and a little bit farther until now you're actually grinding the whole bevel on there. In which case, then they'll change the bevel angle again of the whole thing, and then they'll go back to just hitting the tip and keep going back on that until they run out. That way you're saving time initially on every sharpening, but when it comes time to reset that bevel and grind it all back, you're going to be spending a good bit of time reshaping the bevel on there. So time-wise, it's a bit of a wash whether or not you would want to do a secondary bevel or not, because you're going to be spending just as much time removing all that material once every so often. But you are going to be saving time regularly just focusing on that secondary bevel. Now, if you happen to be a hybrid person and you have a grinder in the shop or some other way where you can take off the majority of the bevel quicker, then this may be a great time saver. And this is where a lot of hybrid people do it, is they will address the main bevel with a power tool and get that main bevel set very quickly. And then they'll freehand sharpen or they'll use their stones to just hit that secondary bevel. And that saves a lot of time because they can do the massive grinding on something that goes very quickly. And then they can get the really nice sharp edge with just these stones. The next thing that a secondary bevel does well is it will increase the angle. So rather than being at a 30, you might be at a 32 or a 35. And the more you increase that angle, the more durable your tip is going to be. It's going to last you longer. And so a lot of people really like that in that it lasts longer. The downside to it is the more you increase the angle, the more force you have to put in the chisel to make the cut. So if you're doing a lot of chopping, that might be very useful because it's going to have that edge that's going to last a little bit longer. But if you're doing a lot of paring where you want that detail cut, it might not be worth it. Now there are a bunch of other reasons why people might want to have a secondary bevel on their chisel, and most of them tend to fall in some version of the more durability or the quicker to use. But the reason I don't do it is because I'm all hand tools, so it's really not going to save me much time to do it, because if I'm going to have to regrind that every now and then, I'm going to have to spend a lot of time at the stone, and that's just work I don't want to do. I'd rather just hit the whole bevel. And it doesn't take that much more time to do it. So for a hand tool person, time-wise, it's not a huge savings. As to more durable of a blade, if I want that, I'm going to just change the whole angle to be at a more durable angle and keep it around that. So it's really not as beneficial to me, and in most cases it just ends up being one more step that I have to think about. And because I'm freehanding, I can't exactly feel that secondary bevel because it's too small. It's much easier to feel a full bevel that will register nicely on the plate, and I can sharpen very easily with that. So for me, it's not very useful. But if you're a hybrid person with a grinder and you want to take off material, that may actually end up saving you time, so it might be something to think about. So next, let's look at plain blades and see about a secondary or a back bevel on it. Now, you could do the exact same thing with a plain blade and put a secondary bevel on it. And I know a lot of people who do that. So everything we talked about with a secondary bevel on a chisel, you could put a secondary bevel on your plain blades and do that as well. But one thing you might do with a plain blade that you won't do with a chisel is put a back bevel on it. And that's rather than just putting a bevel here, you can actually put a little bit of a back bevel on here, so you're taking off a little bit of the tip on the back side. Now, this is a rather exaggerated amount of how much would be taken off. Most of the time it would just be like that, just the tiniest little whip right off the tip to put another little bevel on the back right there. Now, back bevels are for plain blades, as they're not for chisels. You never want to put a back bevel on a chisel. And the reason being is if you are going to be surface referencing, in other words, I'm referencing this and there is a high spot over here, I want that blade to actually connect with that high spot and shave it off so that it's flush. It will reference off of this surface. Because this whole surface is perfectly flat, it will slide on here and dig in. If I put a little bit of a back bevel on there, then I actually have to lift the handle up in order to engage the iron and drive it into the wood. And that's going to start causing me to rotate down into the wood rather than cutting a flat surface all the way across, referencing back here. So you never want to do that with a chisel. But with a plain blade, the bevel isn't up, the bevel is down, and will be going through like this. Unless you're talking about a low angle plane, and then there's a whole bunch of other things that go into that. But with a standard Bailey pattern plane, or most any plane out there, the bevel is down. And so in that case, if you put a bevel on this side, it's not really going to affect anything. The only thing putting a bevel on the back of the iron will do is, number one, is it will increase the angle of attack. Just like putting a secondary bevel on a chisel will increase the angle of attack. Putting on the chisel will, because normally what determines the angle of the cut is the angle of the back of the chisel to the work. And if I put a secondary bevel on that goes on the tip like this, I'm going to be increasing my angle. Again, it's going to make the blade more durable, but it's going to make it harder to push through the wood. Now, one of the most common ways of getting a back bevel on your iron is with the ruler trick. And Rob Cosman really made this famous, or he's been the one who talks about it the most, is once you've done your sharpening, you've done your bevel, and you've cleaned it off and you've gotten rid of that burr on there, then you put the iron down on here, you set this down on here, and rather than allowing it to be level, this raises the back up just a little bit. And you're just going to do a few passes on here, and that's going to take off the material off the back. And it's just going to be a tiny, tiny wisp going all the way across. So when you're doing a back bevel, it's really nothing that's terribly noticeable. It's just a tiny bit right up at the front. And you really don't want the back bevel to be that much because you have a chip breaker on here. And that chip breaker, if you're working with a smoothing plane or you're doing something really detailed, you want to get that up close to the front. So if that back bevel comes back too far, then the chip breaker's got to back up because the chip breaker can't sit on that bevel. It's got to be behind the bevel. So you want to make sure that back bevel is just a tiny little bit so you can still get that chip breaker up close to the tip. So what exactly are the benefits to a back bevel on a chisel? Number one, and the one I talk about the most often, is it makes it a little bit easier for beginners to do freehand sharpening because it kind of takes all the guesswork out of making those edges meet perfectly. You see, what happens is when you're sharpening, you're working on this edge here on the bevel, and you're going to get this little burr that comes off here, and then you're going to do a few strokes on the back, and that burr is going to fall off. And that will give you a perfect tip right on the nose. The problem is, when you're beginning, it's really hard to work on this bevel. It is a small surface, and it becomes very easy to pick the iron up and round over the tip, and you start to get a slightly rounded edge right on the front here. And that rounded edge means you're not getting that sharp tip, you're not getting that burr, and it can be very frustrating for beginners. So what you then do is you come in here with that back bevel, and that back bevel sits on here and takes that off. And what makes it easy is you've got the ruler and you put it on here, and you've got this large reference surface all the way across there that's sitting on the surface. So it makes it very, very easy to guarantee that back bevel is perfect. And so that back bevel can then meet the primary bevel, and you'll get a really, really sharp edge almost guaranteed every time. That guaranteed outcome makes it fantastic for beginners because they know that they're going to get a sharp edge. It's not guesswork. It's not something that they're going to be fiddling around with. And so if you're beginning and having a problem with getting that edge and registering that bevel perfectly, try putting a back bevel on it. You might find that it really helps things out and allows you to get going pretty quickly. Another benefit to the back bevel is that you might not have a perfect iron. And a lot of these antique irons, they're still good steel. They will last you a long time. And I still use an antique iron in most all of my planes. But occasionally I'll get pitting or scratches or scars in the back. And the only way to get those out is to clean up the whole back and smooth the whole thing out. And that takes a lot of time and a lot of work. And sometimes it's just not worth it. And putting a back bevel on basically will just flatten that sharp edge right at the front. And it will save you from having to do the whole surface. Kind of like a secondary bevel saves you from having to do the whole bevel. In this case, the bevel is the whole length of the plane iron. So putting that back bevel on will help you if you have some slight imperfections in the back of your iron. That way you'll get a nice clean edge right up at the front. So if you're working with less than perfect irons, or you're a beginner, or you're having problems sharpening, a back bevel may be an awesome answer for you. Now, I don't do it. Why don't I do it? Because it's an extra step. For basically the same reason why I don't put a secondary bevel on my chisel. It's just an extra step that I don't need to do. It doesn't save me any time. It doesn't help me out. All of my plane irons, I've gotten really good and clean back, so I don't have to worry about that. So it's just one less step having to pull this out and go on it. It just takes more time, so why do it? And so for me, it really doesn't have much of a benefit. Freehanding for me is pretty straightforward. I've spent enough time on it, so I don't think about it, and I get a good clean edge every time. And I've gotten very picky about my irons, and I have good antique irons that will last me a long time, so I don't really need to make sure I clean that up. So for me, the back bevel is really just not as useful. Now, this is the point at which I have to say, lots of arguments come up about back bevels and secondary bevels, and people get very picky about my way is the best way, and this way is the best way, and what I do is the absolute best, and it really doesn't matter. And that's why I like to say, this is what I do, but I have other things that I teach people to do, and there are some times where I suggest that some people do some things differently than I do. Try some things out yourself. Have a little bit of fun. Experiment. You never know until you try it out. And sometimes people do that ruler trick, and it's just like this aha moment where everything suddenly makes sense, and they can get things sharper than they've ever had it before, in which case, fantastic. For me, it's not really a benefit, but that's because I've been sharpening for a long time, and I don't really need it. So experiment, have some fun, be willing to try new things, and anytime someone says, this is the best way to do it, understand that they don't know what they're talking about then. There are other ways to do it that might work better for you. I hope you like this topic. It was one that I've recently gotten a few questions on, and I thought it might be good to lump it all together and do a few on this. This is one of these things that scare a lot of beginners, whether or not they have to do one, or they should do one, or what's better. I hope this answered the questions for you that you might have. If it didn't, or you have some particular thing to add to it, throw it down in the comments below. There are a lot of other benefits and procedures and methods of doing back bevels and secondary bevels, and there are, as anything with hand tools, lots of other ways to accomplish the same thing. So as always, the comments are down below, and I do read through as many as I possibly can. If you do have any questions, comments, concerns, snide remarks, throw them down there. I'd love to see that. And this week, just like every other week, I want to say thank you to the patrons on Patreon. I say it every week, and there's a reason for it. Patrons and members here, people who've clicked the join button, they are the reason why Wood by Wright is still here. So thank you for that. Without your support, Wood by Wright would not exist. So thank you for that, and thanks for keeping the light on and the videos going. So I think that'll about do it for now, and until next time, have a wonderful day. I wonder if a secondary back bevel would help. Oh, I could get into doing trendary bevels. Ooh, this could be fun. Let's go give it a try.